Hello and welcome to marketing91.com. In this video, we are going to cover the topic on golden parachute. Before we proceed any further, please do note that we publish 3 videos daily on YouTube. So please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now let's start with, what is golden parachute? A golden parachute is when a firm and its employee reach an agreement. This employee is usually from the higher management. The agreement says that the employee will be compensated greatly if they are laid off. These can be in the form of severance pay, cash bonuses, stock options, or other benefits. Firms usually define the termination specifically as the outcome of a merger or takeover, also known as change in control benefits. Please note, disability, resignation, or planned retirement does not result in these benefits. Moving further, the golden parachute amount. Based on the agreement, the golden parachute allows the continuation of benefits and salary from 1 to 5 years. CEOs usually get twice or thrice the value of their bonuses and base salary. They also get pension payouts and stock options. And CFOs, COOs, presidents, and various C-suite executives usually get once or twice their base salary. Moving further, the arguments in support of golden parachute. It helps executives deal with takeovers objectively, even if they might lose their job later. 3 arguments in the favor of golden parachute. First, it helps boost revenues. It lets CEOs set long-term goals and thus increase an organization's revenues. Second, it reduces hostile takeovers. Discourage firms trying to take over by making it costlier to do so. It is a part of the poison pill strategy because a firm trying to take over the firm would have to pay golden parachute to the CEO of the firm that is being acquired. And third, it may also help in merger and acquisitions. It becomes easier to employ and retain executives. It is beneficial in industries where there are many mergers. Moving on to the purpose of golden parachute. First, the aim of the golden parachute is to save CEOs and other high-level managers in case of a takeover that could terminate their jobs. Second, they would be secure when other CEO positions might not be easily available. They would thus gladly take up the task. Third, a golden parachute might help keep the CEO's interest in the same as that of shareholders. Fourth, golden parachute gives CEOs security and compensate for income they would have received down the line. Next, thus, they have no reason to be against a merger or acquisition, at least temporarily, which could increase the stock value. Next, senior executives would not have a reason to intervene in the market for corporate control, including acquisition attempts. Next, another aim of golden parachute might be to discourage hostile or unwanted takeovers. And finally, golden parachutes might also increase incentives to hire and keep such executives. Moving on to the criticism of golden parachute. 2 key criticisms are, first, the moral dilemma. Executives know that their job loss will benefit them greatly. They lack the incentive to perform well. Job loss is possible in any profession, and executives already have benefits in this case. The cost of a golden parachute is a fraction of the cost of a takeover. They do not impact the outcome. Gratuitous benefits given to CEOs for agreeing to the acquisition have faced severe criticism. This means that the acquiring firm pays the CEO outside of their own agreed terms. The next criticism is stock options could be vested instantly. According to some experts, some CEOs got golden parachute where stock options could be vested instantly. If a CEO receives benefits after a firm's stock value crashes, then it upsets shareholders. Question about deservedness are brought up. Example, Harry McNeil of Pfizer received a pension deal amounting to $83 million before a job ended. The firm's stock value had gone down by 46% in his tenure. Moving on to golden parachute examples. The most famous example is of Sanjay Jha. When Google paid $12.5 billion to acquire Motorola, the cell phone maker's Indian-born CEO, Sanjay Jha, received $66 million as a golden parachute compensation package as the services were no longer required. Next, WeWork co-founder Adam Neumann received $1.7 billion for stepping down as the company's chairman after its biggest investor, SoftBank, took over the failing company in October 2019. And the final example of Marissa Mayer. Verizon acquired Yahoo officially in June 2017, and consequently, Mayer resigned as Yahoo's CEO, taking $23 million. This payment is a traditional golden parachute triggered by a takeover. So that's it, folks. This brings an end to the topic on golden parachute. These are some of the sources and links referred to for the content in the video. If you've liked the video, do subscribe to our channel where you'll witness 3 new videos daily. Additionally, if you want to view these videos in an organized manner, you can visit freecourses.net. where all our videos are arranged in the form of courses. Thank you and see you in the next video.